Welcome to my YouTube channel. Why we are using reverse power relay in ACB safeties? When two or more generator running in parallel, if there is failure of prime mover from any one of the generator, which leads to reverse power can flow from MSB to alternator, then alternator acts as a motor. Because still the ACB breaker is in closed position, then alternator starts to produce a magnetic field, and due to this magnetic field, rotors rotates and also rotates the prime mover. So in order to protect the prime mover from mechanical damage and to prevent the alternator from motorizing effect, we are using a reverse power relay. If you see the diagram here, during normal power flow, generator has to deliver power to MSB. Then inside the MSB bus bar is there. Another generator also connected with this bus bar. When reverse power flow, it takes power from the bus bar, right? So if you have the relay, means when reverse power flow, it get energized and give a tripping signal to ACB to open the breaker. So in this way, we can protect the prime mover and generator. So it is clear that reverse power relay is a directional relay, right? When reverse power flow, it does not cause reverse rotation and also does not create excess torque. Okay, so I will explain the working of reverse power relay in the end of the video. Causes of reverse power trip. If any one of the prime mover gets stopped due to loop by low pressure trip, jacket cooling water high temperature trip, or overspeed trip. See, these trips are the main trips for the safeties of prime mover. If any one of the trips happen, means governor has to cut off the fuel supply to the prime mover. Then prime mover gets stopped, then reverse power flow will be there. Faulty governor of prime mover also, and loss of excitation in alternator occurs due to AVR malfunction, diode short circuit, surge suppression resistor open circuit, then faulty synchronoscope also. Offloading the generator, usually we are doing it 50 to 100 kilowatt. Why? Means during a ideal condition, the fuel is admitting to the engine, that is mechanical power, that 100 kilowatt is giving to the counter the friction and windage losses. If you are doing it 0 kilowatt, means reverse power flow will be there. That's why we are offloading the generator at 50 to 100 kilowatts, right? Reverse power trip setting for diesel generator is 8 to 15% and turbo generator is 2 to 6%. The setting value can vary from ship to ship and it depends on the maker. For example, if the generator is producing 3000 kilowatt, means for 10% trip setting is 300 kilowatt, right? But when reverse power flow, the value of power reading in controller is minus 300 kilowatt. Why here minus means it takes power from the bus bar when reverse power flow. That's why the value shown in the display is minus 300 kilowatt, right? For time delay of 5 seconds, here why we are using time delay means while paralleling of two generator, there will be a power surges. Then reverse power flow will be there. So to prevent the reverse power tripping due to power surges, we are using a time delay of 5 seconds. Why TG is less tripping setting compared to DG? Because TG has less friction and windage losses and less power required to overspeeding the turbine at ideal. That's why it is a low trip setting, right? The working of reverse power relay has two coils, one for PT, another for CT. Sometimes server will ask cross question in reverse power relay. Why we are using two coil, why not one coil? Because we need to calculate the power. The basic formula for power is voltage into current. That's why we are using a PT and CT, right? Then another question will be there. Why we need to calculate the power, why not current? Because it is difficult to calculate the reverse current direction in AC. That's why we are calculating the power, right? If you see the diagram here, PT has more number of turn and high inductance. We know that high inductive loads are current lag the voltage by 90 degrees. So due to the lagging current in PT, the magnetic field produced in this coil also lags the voltage by 90 degrees. So the magnetic flux of phi 1, if you see the phasor diagram here, flux phi 1 which lags the voltage by 90 degrees, right? Then current coil, it has less number of turn and low inductance. So due to low inductance, the magnetic flux produced in this coil also lags the voltage less compared to PT. So due to this difference between this magnetic fluxes, so this both the magnetic field are passes through this aluminum disc, then induced eddy current produces a driving torque that try to rotate the disc. So under normal condition, disc rotates in normal direction and moving contact does not closes the fixed contact, right? But during reverse power flow, disc rotates in reverse direction, then moving contact closes the fixed contact, then circuit will be closed, then tripping signal is given to the ACB trip coil, then trip coil open the ACB breaker. So in this way, we protect the prime mover and generator, right? This is the working of reverse power relay.